Hey guys, welcome back. Today I am finally going to be decorating this really large bookshelf behind me. I feel like I've been talking about decorating this bookshelf for so long, but I feel like I finally collected enough items that can fill up this really large bookshelf. If you are wondering where anything is from that I end up putting on my shelves, I will link a couple hauls down below where I feel like the majority of this stuff is from. Also, if you guys kind of want to see more of the room or how we ended up putting these shelves together really affordably, feel free to check out the room makeover that I did on this room. I'll have it linked above and I'll link that video down below too. So if you haven't checked that out, make sure to do that. Before you start decorating bookshelf, I think it's really important to just kind of figure out your color scheme. And I decided that I'm going to do lots of gold, silver, rose gold, pastel, just keep it really light and girly and fun. And also, I want to still have it look like me and personalize it a little bit. So that's something I'm gonna keep in mind too as I'm decorating today. So I really hope that you guys enjoy, and let's just go ahead and start decorating. All right guys, so this is my really plain empty bookshelf. I love it though. It's really cool. My dad helped put it together and put that crown molding on the top and stuff. And then over here is all the stuff that I have to decorate my shelf. As you can tell, everything is like super, super girly. There's a lot of gold, a lot of silver, a lot of pink, a lot of gold for the most part, but you guys know how much I love gold. So anyway, I'm going to just start decorating. I kind of just don't even know where to start. I also wanted to get like a couple baskets to go down here on the bottom shelves, but I just haven't found anything that fit right yet. So I'm still on the lookout for that. And if you guys end up seeing anything, please send me a picture or something, because I've been having the hardest time finding some baskets to store things in for down there. So first I'm going to start with these really pretty boxes. These are from Target, I think last year around Christmas. It's by the sugar paper line, but I love these boxes so much. And I knew that I wanted these to be on the bookshelf, but I definitely want to space things out and not keep like similar things really, really close to each other or all in the same row or anything like that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try to space these out on the bookshelf. So I love these little lights, but this is also something too where they're very, very similar, so I don't want to keep them too close together. So this is just kind of what I've come up with so far. I still have a lot of stuff that I want to put on the bookshelf, but I'm not sure if I'm even going to be able to end up using all of it. So I actually don't have that many books for the bookshelf. So I just wanted to show you guys what I do have. As you guys know, I'm obsessed with cute little notebooks from like TJ Maxx and stuff. So I have quite a few of those. Got like three of those and they're all like super, super pretty. So obviously I buy all these really cute journals and stuff and I don't use them. And then next, just a pretty little girl boss book. I mainly just bought that just because I thought it was really cute. And then I do have this 2016 planner. You guys also probably know I go through planners like crazy. So this is one from 2016. It was a Kate Spade one, but it's just so pretty because it has like the gold polka dots on it and stuff. And then this is also another one, which is just really pretty. And then I found this little book here, and it actually had a yellow cover on it, and I just took it off and I noticed it was white with like gold writing on it. So it's actually really, really beautiful. This is actually from TJ Maxx too. So I don't have a big collection of like really pretty books or anything. I do have these over here as well, which I think are all from TJ Maxx too. These are like, these big ones here are more like coffee table books that I got last year. I have a Kate Spade one and then this Rebecca Atwood one. So this is like a really pretty living with pattern book.
that I just think has some really fun inspiration in it for your house and stuff like that. So anyway, I just think these books are really cool. And then this is the Amy Song, like little Instagram book and stuff that has some fun stuff in it. I just think this book is so pretty. Anyway, that's really all the books I have. If you guys are decorating your bookshelf though, and you're wondering what kind of books to use, like if you don't have stuff like this, I actually thought a really good idea that my sister-in-law did. She actually like covered a lot of old books that she had just like with pretty wrapping paper and stuff. So that's something that you could do too, like, you know, when you had to cover your books in high school, like that's kind of what she did, and then they looked really, really pretty on the outside. So I thought that was a really cool idea too. I don't think I'm gonna do any of that because I have, you know, some pretty stuff that I can put up there for now, but I might eventually if I do want some more books. The shelf is coming along really well, but a couple things that run through my head that I just thought would be kind of good to share with you guys is I am going to change up that shelf and this shelf, just which one I put them on, just because they're kind of like a similar shape and they're laying the exact same way. So I don't really want those to be right next to each other. Also, I don't really like that those two boxes are so similar and then they're both like on the same side of that shelf. Like I just think that they need to be spread out more. So that's kind of what I'm trying to figure out right now. I also did add this really cool Dooney and Burke purse. I'll pull it down so I can show you guys. But this purse I actually got in high school, or my mom got it for me. I don't know if you guys remember, like Lindsay Lohan had one of these, I think, and that's why I wanted one when I was a teenager. So this was like kind of one of my first designer bags, but I do think it's just so cute. I have a feeling these are going to come back in style, but I love it, and I thought it just added a really fun personal touch to the shelf. So the shelf is almost done. I just have a couple more things that I feel like I need to put on here. So right here in this top shelf, I need a little something. And then also on this one too. I've been looking at it and just trying to figure out like what I wanted to do. And I actually ended up pulling out these old shoes that were in my old closet at my parents' house. And I used to have like a bunch of shoes in my closet that like were just on display that I didn't actually wear. These ones, probably never worn. I don't even remember why I got these or for what. I don't even know why I have them. Probably never worn. Pretty sure they're from TJ Maxx, but these were on display. They're like super tall, just really fun high heels. And then also these ones, guys, these were actually my grandmother's high heels. How crazy are these? Like, I have no idea how she wore these. Like, I don't know. They're awesome, though. And it looks like she actually did wear them. They were probably pretty expensive shoes back in the day, but I just think they're so cool. I would never, ever wear them just because it looks like they would probably be pretty uncomfortable. And of course, I wouldn't want to like ruin them or anything. But I thought, I don't know, maybe it would be really cool to put the shoes up there. It would be a really fun personal touch and just make it look super girly. I love how I put the purse on there, so we'll see how the shoes end up looking too. I do need to get a couple pictures to put in this frame. This was on clearance at TJ Maxx and was in a haul, but I still need to get a couple pictures of my dog printed off so I can put those in there. And then I think that's pretty much it, besides getting a couple baskets or something to go on these two bottom shelves, which I cannot find baskets. So please, guys, give me some information. Have you seen anything that would look really cute on here? I just want baskets so I have like some room for like storage and stuff down there. Oh my gosh, so I love the way the shoes turned out up there. Oh my goodness, how cool does that look? I don't know, it might not be for everybody, but it's totally me. I love the shoes up there. So I think that the whole entire bookshelf turned out so stinking beautiful. I love it. I really hope that you guys got some inspiration from this video. Like I said, I do need to get some little baskets or something for down here. And then also all of these little guys, like that one, and then the smaller one up here next to the shoe. Those all need batteries in them because those do all light up. And I just think it's just gonna make it look so beautiful with all the little lights and stuff like that. So girly, so much fun. I also didn't even use everything that I was thinking maybe I would use. Like I had this really cute little plant from TJ Maxx, and then I had this little thing. So I didn't even use both of those. Didn't really need to use any of that stuff. But I, for the most part, pretty much used all of the decor and now just need some baskets for the bottom. So please, guys, comment below. Let me know if you've seen any baskets or send me pictures on Instagram of anything that you think might work for down there because I just have no idea what's gonna work. So I hope you guys loved watching me decorate this bookshelf. Like I said at the beginning of the video, if you guys want to know where anything is from, make sure to check out my past hauls that I've done that the majority of this stuff was in. So I'll link both of those down below. Make sure to check them out if you haven't already. If you guys have any other ideas for me for this shelf, especially baskets, let me know. Give this video a thumbs up if you loved it and you love decorating videos. Also, please make sure to go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed already, and I would appreciate it so much. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you really soon in my next video.